Hey guys, here's what we're building today. This is a video thumbnail with a zoom hover effect. When you click it, it loads a YouTube video in an overlay. You can use this component to add a video to your website without sacrificing performance, since the YouTube player is only loaded when needed. Let's begin with a blank design. The first step is to lay down the components. Drop a container, then a row and a column. Set the row to fit two columns and center them. For the thumbnail, we will drop a div, a link, and an image. This will turn the entire image into a link. Double-click the link to remove the text. Then, paste the URL of the YouTube video you want to load as the href attribute. Now let's import a couple of images. You can find these linked in the video description. Double-click and select the video thumbnail. Make the image responsive. Add a bit of padding to the body. Then, select the div and give it a shadow and a custom Video Thumb class name. We are now ready to write some CSS. Open the style sheet and create the first blocks targeting the Video Thumb class. This block sets overflow to hidden so that the border radius can work. It also defines a transition, which results in a smooth animation on hover. To create the play arrow, we will need to be a bit more creative. Here, I am using the before pseudo element. This creates a virtual element which we can style entirely with CSS. I've given it an absolute positioning so that it spans the entire video thumbnail. The play arrow SVG is set as a background image. You can make it bigger by increasing this size. This drop shadow gives it extra contrast, and the z-index here makes it appear above the thumbnail image. Pointer events none makes it transparent to clicks so that it doesn't block the link below it from being clicked. And finally, the arrow is hidden with opacity 0, which turns to 1 on hover. The transition property turns this change into a smooth hover animation. Now we need to write some JavaScript code, which will load the video in an overlay. Create a new JavaScript file and open it. To not bore you with watching a guy type for 20 minutes, I will go ahead and paste the code I wrote earlier. You can find it in the description. The first thing our code does is create a bootstrap modal. Inside it, we have an iframe in the 16:9 ratio. This iframe is where we will be loading the YouTube video. Here, we initialize a bunch of variables and use the Bootstrap library to get a modal instance. This will allow us to show the modal later. We also listen for the hidden event. The Bootstrap library triggers this whenever the modal is closed. Inside, we remove the iframe from the page and reset its source attribute so that the video stops playing. Next, we select all the elements with the Video Thumb class on the page and iterate over them with for each. This way, there can be multiple video thumbnails on the page and they will all work. Finally, we check whether the link in the thumbnail is a supported YouTube URL. If it is, we add a click handler. When the user clicks the thumbnail, we set the iframe to the video embed page and show the modal. And with this, our player is ready. I published it to the online library, and you can download it in your Bootstrap Studio project. Just search for Overlay Video Player. You can also find all the code and images in the description. What would you like to see next? Write a comment below and subscribe to get notified of our next videos.